Hello and good morning, it's Phil Thach and I'm here today at the Tennessee River Park, the Curtain Pole Road Pond area. And I came here to try to find some hooded mergansers this morning. Didn't have any luck at all with that. As a matter of fact, when I first drove by here, the place was closed. I went down to another area on the park and looked around for just a minute and came back and they had opened it up. I think they were doing some leaf blowing in the parking lot, so they closed it. But no luck with the hooded mergansers. But I did find a white-throated sparrow, which is a wintertime visitor to our area. And I was able to get really close to it, but it was in really thick brush and it was really hard to make a photograph of it. If I got close enough to where I could get it in the frame, I was using the 800 lens, this lens, the 800 millimeter f11, which is a great bird lens, especially for a low resolution full frame camera like the R6, but its minimum focus distance is terrible. And in order to get the bird in the frame, I couldn't back up far enough to work with this lens. So I switched to a much more expensive lens. I switched to the 100 to 500 f4.5 to 7.1, I think. Really expensive lens, super sharp lens, fantastic lens. But I don't use it for birding very much with the R6 because it's only 500 millimeters and the R6 is low resolution, so you need to crop a lot. But I was getting so close to this white-throated sparrow that I switched over to the 100 to 500, which has a much better minimum focus distance, and was able to get a couple of shots of the white-throated sparrow. So let's look at those and I'll keep working. I always enjoy getting photographs of white-throated sparrows, a wintertime visitor to our area here in Chattanooga, Tennessee. And look at all of the brush and thicket I had to shoot through to get this shot. And still, the head is perfectly in focus. Not the greatest shot ever, but I do like it quite a bit. Now, this shot right here, there's almost nothing in front of the bird. And somehow, I kind of like the other photograph better, which is really strange. But the other photograph kind of tells the story better of my morning and how difficult it was to get a photograph of this bird because most of the time, it was blocked by thicket. I worked on the white-throated sparrow some more. It's funny to spend 45 minutes working on one tiny little bird. But gosh, it's hard to get a good picture of it because it's in thickets like that right there. And sometimes it would come over here to this thicket. And, you know, it was really tricky to get a decent shot. And I'm so glad that I carried the 100 to 500 because I would not have gotten any shots with the 800 F11. The bird was just too close. You know, I've only got this far back to go when shooting over there, or this far back to go when shooting over here. So I needed a lens with a really good minimum focus distance, and the 100 to 500 is definitely that. Not quite as much range as I would like on the R6. Maybe one day they'll make an APS-C camera that I can hook that lens up to, but until then, today it's working well. Here are a couple of more photographs of the beautiful white-throated sparrow. In this photograph, the bird is actually singing during the shot, which I thought was pretty cool. And this gives some detail of the thorns and all the things that the bird was in while I was trying to make its photograph. Now, this photograph here, of course, I probably made 100 photographs of the little white-throated sparrow, and I'm only sharing 4 with you. But this photograph right here is the one that made me look at the back of the camera and say, okay, I finally have a decent shot. Although it's probably not my favorite of the 4 I shared. I came down to this area right behind Chattanooga State where the walking path is and the trees and the river down below, and did some more bird photography there. I saw some really interesting birds. I saw a brown-headed nuthatch and cedar waxwings, which are both, you know, just feathering your cap to get a picture of those. And I made some pictures of them, but I don't think I'm happy with any of them at all. If there are some that are anywhere near presentable, we'll look at those now, but I got a bad feeling about it. We'll start off with this photograph of a male northern cardinal. I got this on the ground. I actually sat down on the ground myself, and I can't believe I didn't spook it. Somebody ended up riding by on a bicycle and spooking it. I'm not happy with this photograph at all, other than it's sharp. Here is a female eastern bluebird that I photographed in the area near Chattanooga State. Just a beautiful little bird. There was a lot more branches and things in this shot, which I ended up taking out. Sometimes I'm able to do that, sometimes I'm not. And here is the brown-headed nuthatch. I didn't think I got any photographs at all that were even close to presentable, but I kind of like this shot. It's not a great shot at all. I think the white-throated sparrow shots are way better, but I kind of like this shot and the color in the background. Here is one more brown-headed nuthatch photograph for you. This one has all sorts of problems. It's not even perfectly sharp, I don't think, but I wanted to give you a little bit more of what the brown-headed nuthatch looks like. Now, this is a cedar waxwing. It has a mask like it's Zorro or something. They are just so beautiful. The smooth colors, the way the brown transitions to yellow, and they may be one of the most photogenic birds out there. Just really beautiful, even though both of these photographs are really not very good, especially this second one. It's just amazing how beautiful and photogenic the cedar waxwing is. I don't see them very often. I was really happy to see them today.
Well, bird photography is strange. You know, you struggle and you struggle and you struggle, and then all of a sudden something happens. That's the Chickamauga Marina behind me. This is on the upriver side of the dam where I was before. I was on the downriver side of the dam at Chattanooga State, or behind Chattanooga State. And I came over here and just kind of rolled through slowly. It's really getting pretty bright and harsh light. But as I rolled through, I wasn't finding anything at all to photograph. And well, I was on the way back out, and I was slow rolling. And right here in this field by the marina was a couple of killdeer. So I took a moment to photograph them. And the light was coming from this direction, so I had pretty decent light. And I think for the first time in this video since the white-throated sparrow at the beginning, I think I finally got a decent bird photograph. And I was just about to leave.
I was a lot more happy with this photograph as I looked at it on the back of the camera than I was when I got home and worked on it to present it to you. It's just there's too much light is the problem with this photograph. But it is a beautiful bird, and I was happy to get a decent photograph of it, but I would have liked for it to have been a little bit better.
All right. Well, thank you so much for joining me today for this bird photography struggle adventure. Hopefully at least one or two of the photos you enjoyed. I enjoyed the process, even though I wasn't able to find as many birds and get good shots of them as I would have liked. It's always a pleasure to get out and wander around looking for birds. So thanks for joining me. If you like the content, thumbs up's greatly appreciated. And as always, I look forward to seeing you in the next one. Bye-bye.